Hey everyone, I was recently looking to buy two power over Ethernet gigabit switches, but the prices of the normal, reputable brands like Netgear and TP-Link seemed quite high. So I went looking for other brands, and Mercusys popped up. They were cheap, less than half the price of other gigabit PoE switches. They also had great reviews, shown as 4.7 out of 5 stars on Amazon. I'd previously discussed why the make of the network switch doesn't really matter. So I took my own advice and I bought the MS108GP from a company I'd never heard of before. When it arrived, I noticed that it had a big TP-Link sticker on the box, given a 3-year warranty. Nice. I hadn't realized this before buying it, but Mercusys basically gives you TP-Link's firmware and reliability at a much cheaper price due to Mercusys being the budget networking brand of TP-Link. While Mercusys sell a range of networking products, including routers and normal switches, this particular one is a power over Ethernet switch, meaning that it can send both internet data and electrical power down the Ethernet cable, powering a range of devices, including CCTV cameras. And that's exactly what I use these switches for. I have a few 3K and 4K cameras that are powered solely with an Ethernet cable, and then they record 24/7 to my Synology NAS. This means that these Mercusys switches perform a crucial role. They need to power multiple cameras and ensure that a large amount of data is sent reliably through the switch. So far, Mercusys ticks all the boxes. Now, this device is not a managed switch, meaning I'm a bit limited in what investigations I can carry out on this switch. After all, there's no management dashboard that then allows me to monitor and modify the traffic flows to the connected devices. But I've been using these two Mercusys switches for a month so far, and I've had no issues with them. There were never any gaps in my 24/7 recordings, and also I can access and modify my PoE cameras, recordings, and settings anytime I want, without experiencing any blips or anything like that. So that's always a good sign. Energy usage is super low too. At idle, it uses around 1 watt of energy, and then when I plug in each of my Anker PoE cameras, the energy use jumps up around 2.5 watts on average. As you can see, it jumps around a bit, but it's over 3 watts when the first camera is plugged in. Once the second camera is plugged in, it settles down close to 6 watts. That's entirely expected though. These are power over Ethernet cameras, meaning that the more PoE devices you add, the more power is consumed by the PoE switch. This brings us on to the only bad point of this Mercusys switch, actually. A PoE switch will have a power budget, which is basically the maximum amount of power that it can supply in total. This particular Mercusys switch can supply a total of 65 watts of power across the 7 PoE ports. This compares to some rivals' switches that can supply 123 watts or more across their power over Ethernet switches, albeit at a much higher price. This Mercusys one is more than 4 times cheaper than the Netgear one I just showed. And in my case, 65 watts of power is sufficient. Even if I hooked up 7 PoE cameras, only 15 watts of power in total would be needed. So that's fine for my use, although there are some power over Ethernet devices, such as wireless access points, that require up to 45 watts of power each. So you then struggle to use those with this particular Mercusys switch. The different power deliveries over Ethernet are known as classes, and this Mercusys switch supports up to class 4 devices, basically up to 30 watts of power to an individual device, as per the 802.3AT standard. That's good enough for me, but big power users of PoE, see what I did there, but need to look elsewhere. Turning back to the general features of this switch, it supports up to gigabit speeds, which is good because some budget PoE devices are still capped at 100 megabit speeds. This is an active PoE switch, and as I discuss more in another video, this basically means that you can then plug in non-PoE devices freely without worrying about them getting fried. This switch also allows you to turn on port isolation via a physical switch on the back, and this separates each device so they can't see each other, preventing potential snooping risks. Another cool feature is that power over Ethernet can lose power when the Ethernet cable is run across a very long distance. My arms aren't long enough. But thankfully, this switch has another button that basically allows you to extend the power of Ethernet range up to 250 meters, although this then drops the internet speeds down to just 10 megabits, which is naturally quite slow. But if you did have a PoE device that was really far away, this could be a useful feature for you. The device itself looks and feels really nice. It has a metal case, which I always prefer to plastic cases. Not only are metal switches better for cooling reasons, but they look better, in my opinion, as well. The switch runs really quietly too. I can barely hear anything unless I put my ear right next to it. I can't hear a thing. Wait. You can also wall mount this, as expected, with screws or nails. Before wrapping up, there's one other really important thing I have to mention. The size of the port LEDs. Nope, I haven't hit my head. This is actually a really important point. I bought a TP-Link switch a few months ago, and the port LEDs were tiny on it. I was constantly looking at it and thinking that my devices are all gone offline. Thankfully, this Mercusys switch has proper size LEDs that clearly show when data and power is flowing through a port. And that wraps up this review. I should point out that I haven't been sent this product for free, and I'm not being paid to just say nice things about it. Mercusys and TP-Link probably don't know I exist, which makes me sad. I purchased this switch with my own cold, hard cash, rather digital payment, because I needed this product, and it seems like a really good product I'd happily buy from Mercusys again. I have only been using this switch for a month though, so if I experience problems down the line, I'll let you know down in the comments. And thanks for watching this video, I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.